And so many things to do.
Margaret Ratliff might say truth is crueler than fiction.
It's something that nobody should have to deal with.
Her birth father died when she and her younger sister Martha were infants. Their birth mother died when they were toddlers. For nearly two decades, Michael Peterson is who they've called Dad. Kathleen Peterson was always Mom. Now their dad is charged with murdering their mother.
We've looked at Dad and we were like, Dad, we know you didn't do it. And he's like, of course I didn't do it, you know? And I've never had a doubt in my mind. Just the simple fact that they loved each other so much.
Peterson was charged a year and a half ago. 2 weeks ago, the body of Margaret and Martha's birth mother, Elizabeth Ratliff, was exhumed. The girls always believed their mother died after falling down the stairs from a stroke. Yesterday, the Chapel Hill medical examiner completed an autopsy, concluding Elizabeth Ratliff was murdered, blunt force trauma. The Durham district attorney wants to link Michael Peterson to the death.
I know that Dad's innocent. I know that he didn't kill either of my mothers. It's just ridiculous.
Peterson's attorney believes it's ridiculous, too. In an exhaustive motion filed today, David Rudolph argues the Ratliff autopsy should not be allowed in the courtroom.
My client ought to be judged on the evidence in this case, not on whether or not some woman who he happened to be friends with died of a stroke, as everyone believed for years, or of something else that he had zero to do with.
All of this absorbed by Ratliff's two birth daughters, both in their 20s, both trying to attend college and find some sense of normalcy.
How do you deal with the reality that Michael, your father, may be convicted and put in prison for the rest of his life?
I can't believe that any jury would sit there and convict my dad. After all the evidence has shown, there's absolutely no way.
The jury that makes that decision will be selected soon. Jury selection starts Monday.